गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनदर टॉपिक, दैट इज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लासेस ऑफ वेरियस फंगी. इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ऑल द जनरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ फंगी. आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट द दे आर क्लासेस ऑफ फंगी एंड दीज क्लासेस आर एक्चुअली डिपेंडेंट अपॉन द morphology of the fungi, that is appearance of fungi, and moreover they also depend upon the type of reproduction. So there are actually four classes of fungi, and the first one is phycomycetes, which we are going to discuss. Now phycomycetes may be present in humid atmosphere, in the soil, in the damp area where too much of water is present. They are decomposers, some of them are parasitic in nature. Now let us talk about their morphology. Initially I have told you certain things in my previous lecture, that the this fungi consists of hypha which may be interconnected with each other to form a structure which is called as mycelium. These hypha can have cross walls, they may not have cross walls, they may have cross walls, some of them may not have a cross wall. So when they are not having a cross wall, the nucleus, the hypha is multinucleated, and it is called as, the mycelium is called as sinocytic. So in case of phycomycetes, you will observe that the hypha do not contains any kind of separate walls, or you can say septa or walls are not present. In those mycelium where the septa or walls are not present, where septa and walls are not present, use the term sinocytic, or for the hyphae use the term aseptic, for the whole mycelium you use the term sinocytic. So this class phycomycetes, all the fungi which belong to this class, they are found everywhere, mostly in damp area where too much of humid atmosphere is present, humid conditions are present, and they do not have septate walls, they do not have walls. See, when the hypha is present horizontally on the surface, on the soil, it is present horizontally, it is called to be a stolon, S-T-O-L-O-N. When they are present inside the soil, it acts like roots, but they are not actually true roots, they act like roots. They have the function of roots. They can draw important nutrients and water from these thin filaments. This kind of special hyphae are called as rhizoids. Some of the hyphae, they are negatively geotropic. Negatively geotropic. That means they move upward from the soil. And these hyphae are called as sporangiopores. These special hyphae are called as sporangiospores. The sporangiopores will, at the tip of the hyphae, they swell and start producing spores. these structure which you can see the swelling at the tip of the hyphae, this is called as sporangium. Sporangium in singular, or it is called as in plural, you can say sporangia. And inside the sporangium you can see these spores. These spores are called as sporangiospores. See, there is a difference. This is sporangiospores, S-P-O-R-E-S, while this special hyphae which bears sporangium, which has sporangium at the at its tip, is called as sporangiopores. The spelling is different, P-O-R-E and here S-P-O-R-E. These are spores which are present in sporangium, the swelled part, the tip of the hyphae. Inside it there are certain spores present which are called as sporangiospores. Okay, now I have told you about the hyphae. The hyphae can be categorized into three categories. If it is growing horizontally very near to the surface of the soil, it is called as stolon. If it is growing inside the roots and function as roots in order to collect water and nutrients from the soil, in order to draw the water and nutrients from the soil, it is called as rhizoids. And when it is growing upward, that is called as negatively geotropic, it is called as sporangiopore. And it contains the, at its tip, it contains a swelling, a structure, an envelope, which is called as sporangium. Inside the sporangium, spores are present, which are called as sporangiospores. Okay. Now, let us discuss something else. Let us discuss the life cycle of Phycomyces. The example of Phycomyces includes Rhizopus. Rhizopus and parasitic form Albugo. Now let us look at a life cycle. In case of asexual reproduction, these produce spores. For example, these are the mycelium. This is special hyphae which is called as sporangiopores, and at its tip it has a swelling which is called as sporangia or sporangium. These tips have spores. Now the spores can get liberated outside, can released outside, fall on the soil, and it may give rise to mycelium after some time. The mycelium will be aseptate as well as cenocytic, will not have any crossroads. Okay. Now let us discuss, let me tell you one more thing. The sexual cycle in case of Phycomyces. Let us discuss the sexual cycle in case of Phycomyces. Sexual cycle in case of Phycomyces. Okay. I have told you that sexual reproduction in case of fungi can occur by conjugation, gametangial copulation, or by the tangential contact. So in this case, what happens is the two different mycelium having hyphae, special hyphae, starts to get close to each other. This is plus stain and this is minus stain. Two hyphae belonging to two different mycelium, they are getting closer to each other. Afterwards, they are getting in contact with each other. They touch each other protoplast. Now the walls of the protoplast dissolve after some time and they will form a structure. They will form a structure which is now called as zygospore. Now these hyphae remain attached with their mycelium but behave as sex cells now. The two different hyphae of two different mycelium, they start behaving as sex cells. Gets fused with each other, form a structure which is called as zygospore, and after this what happens is when they fuses with each other, they form a structure which is called as zygospores, and after this what happens is these structure may get released from the mycelium and these zygospore may form a structure which is called as sporangiophore. At its tip of the sporangiophore, at the tip of the hyphae, you see these zygospore have formed a special hyphae which is called as sporangiophore. At the tip of the sporangiophore, swelling takes place, and inside this spores starts to form by the process of meiosis. Meiosis is reduction division, where the cell start dividing. Meiosis is of two kind. Meiosis first, that is represented by M1 at above. Each of these cells will undergo meiosis second, that is represented by M2, and they form four different kind of cells or spores. Now this will happen in this sporangium. Here four different spores will be formed. You can also say four different cells will be formed. The nucleus will divide twice to form four different cells or spores, and these spores will be called as sporangiospores. Sporangiospores. Ultimately, the wall of the sporangium will burst. And all the sporangiospores will be liberated outside. They will fall on the soil and will give rise to another mycelium. So that is all about sexual reproduction in phycomycetes. I have already told you that here reproduction takes place by sporangium sporangiophores which have a on its tip there is a membrane which is called as sporangium, and inside that spores are formed which is called as sporangiophores. Now I have already given you example also rhizopus and albugo. So this is all about class phycomycetes. There are certain things to remember in class phycomycetes, that they live in damp soil or damp areas where water is available. They have aseptate body, that is not divided by a septa. The multinucleated and aseptate body, the mycelium is called as cenocytic. Then they have asexual reproduction, which I have already told you about asexual reproduction. They have a structure, a special hyphae which is called as sporangiophores, P-H-O-R-E-S. And at the tip of the sporangiophores, there is a swelling which is called as sporangium. Inside the swelling there are spores. Spores are formed, and when these spores are liberated, they will again give rise to new mycelium. That is asexual reproduction. In case of sexual reproduction, two different mycelium hyphae are present in it. They belong to two different mycelium. They come very close to each other. Their protoplast fuses. Protoplast means cytoplasmic content, as well as their nucleus gets fused, and they form a structure which is called a zygospore. These zygospore, after some time, they get detached from the parent plant, and they can give rise to a new erect, E-R-E-C-T, erect hyphae, a special hyphae which is called a sporangiophores. At its tips, sporangium develops, and inside the sporangium, the spores are formed with the help of meiosis. That means four spores are formed. Each spore, after its release, will give rise to new mycelium. That is how the sexual reproduction in case of phycomycetes occur. So now let us talk about another class of fungi. Another class of fungi, and that is we'll be discussing about class Ascomycetes. We'll be discussing about class Ascomycetes. Ascomycetes class has about 30,000 species of fungi. About 30,000 species of fungi are present in Ascomycetes. And since this has a sac-like structure, they are called to be Ascomycetes. Now let us discuss about their morphology, and then we'll be discussing about its reproduction with examples. Okay. These Ascomycetes may be obligate parasites. These may be decomposers. Many of them are decomposers also. And morphology is slightly different from Phycomycetes because they are branched as well as septate. They are branched and septate. They are branch and septate. Okay, here in this case asexual reproduction occurs by formation of conidia. Asexual reproduction occurs by formation of conidia. Now let me give you an example of this. These are special hyphae called as conidiopores, erect hyphae growing upward. These have rhizoids also, and they have stolon hyphae which grows horizontally on the soil. These conidiophore, they have structure like this. See, these are all spores, conidiospores. These are called as conidiospores. Conidiospores. These are called as conidiospores. See, one thing is very different from class Phycomyces. In class Phycomyces, you observed that there was a wall-like structure in which the spores were present. Here you won't find the wall-like structure. Therefore, these spores are called to be exogenously produced. These are exogenously produced. They do not have any envelope outside it. You can see here, this is a spore lying outside naked. These are all spores. Now, after their liberation, that is when they are released, and when they fall on the soil, they can again give rise to a mycelium. So this is how it takes place. Example is Aspergillus. In case of Aspergillus, now let us talk about, see, we have I was discussing about only the asexual reproduction in case of this class is called as Ascomycetes. Ascomycetes. I was discussing about Ascomycetes, and that is I was discussing about asexual reproduction. Now let us discuss about sexual reproduction in case of Ascomycetes. Okay. Let us discuss about sexual reproduction in case of sexual reproduction in case of Ascomycetes. Now Ascomycetes, many fungi belong to Ascomycetes, such as Penicillium, Aspergillus, Claviceps, Neurospora. So in case of Penicillium, what happens is, we just have a small diagram of the life cycle of the Penicillium. Okay, there are two special hyphae in which the sexual organs are found, reproductive organs are found. See, this white part is called as ascogonium. This is a female reproductive organ, and this purple part, this is called as antheridium. Now, ascogonium and antheridium may develop in the same hyphae, special hyphae, or they may develop in two different hyphae belonging to the same mycelium. Now, these are septate. So, since I have not drawn the walls, we assume that walls are drawn. These are septate, having cross walls. Now, these lie very close to each other. Or you can say that the male antheridium part, it coils around the ascogonium. See, there is a coiling. Now what happens is, in the male part, nucleus is present. And in the female part also, nucleus is present. All the nucleus of the male part, it migrates to the female part. All the nucleus which is present in the male part, it migrates. See, these are the nucleus of the females, and here small nucleus are present in the males. Let me draw here in order to tell you. Suppose this is a male part, and very close to it female hypha is present, and this is a nucleus of the male part, and these are the nucleus of the female part. So the male nucleus will migrate to the female part. That is, from the antheridium it will migrate and come inside the ascogonium, and then fusion takes place. Then what happens is fusion of the two nuclei take place, and this becomes now diploid. Now this happens in the tip part, that is all the tip part of the hyphae, the above part of the hyphae, both in case of ascogonium and antheridium, this kind of migration happens, and therefore this whole part, the tip region of the ascogonium, this is called as fruiting body, the tip part of the female hyphae, is called as ascocarp. That is called as ascocarp. Now what happens inside the ascocarp after the fusion of the male nuclei and the female nuclei? A cell is formed which is diploid. See, in earlier classes you must have heard about, since in, you are in class 11th, you must have heard about mitosis and meiosis. Though a mechanism of mitosis and meiosis will be explained to you in later chapters, but let me tell you things. This cell, which contains the male nuclei and the female nuclei, both fused together, will now first of all undergo mitosis. So you know that in mitosis, out of one cell, two cells are formed. So these two cells are formed after mitosis. Now what happens to these two cells? Both of these two cells will undergo meiosis. Now meiosis is a two-step process, which is indicated by meiosis first and meiosis second. Now this first cell will again give rise to two cells, and this cell will again give rise to two cells. Now four cells have been formed. Now of these four cells, each cells will undergo meiosis second also. Each cell will undergo meiosis second also. Now ultimately what will happen is, eight cells are formed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. See, this happens in case of Ascobonium. 8 cells, 8 spores are formed, and these 8 spores, since 1 mitosis and 2 meiosis has occurred, so naturally from 1 cell 8 cells will be formed, and these 8 spores or cells are called as ascospores. Ascospores. Since these ascospores, after their release from the ascogonium, when they will fall on the soil, after some time they will start forming mycelium, and they will give rise to a mycelium after some time. Full formed mycelium, that is a fungi, another fungi. So this is how sexual reproduction takes place in case of Ascomycetes. It is to be remembered here that in case of Ascomycetes, sexual organs are formed, and these sexual organs are antheridium and ascogonium. The tip of the ascogonium is the place where ascospores are formed, because migration of the male nuclei takes place. The male nuclei, it leaves the antheridium and it enters the ascogonium. Inside the ascogonium, inside each cell of the ascogonium, you know, it is a structure which has a cross walls. So this is divided structure having a cross wall, it is called as ascus, and each ascus will contain 8 ascospores. It will contain 8 ascospores. For example, this will contain 8 ascospores, this will contain 8 ascospores, this will contain 8 ascospores. So each ascus will contain 8 ascospores. The upper part of the ascogonium will behave as a fruiting body, and the name of the fruiting body is called as ascoscarp. Ascoscarp. In each ascoscarp, there will be number of ascus. Each cell divided having a cross wall will behave as ascus. Inside each ascus, there will be 8 ascospores. These ascospores have been formed because of mitosis followed by meiosis first and meiosis second. So naturally, I think you have understood this. Each ascospores, when they are released outside from the ascogonium, or you can say from each and every ascus which is present in the ascogonium, they will, after getting into soil, they will again give rise to a mycelium. I hope you have understood this. Now let us start with another class, that is called as Basidiomycetes. That is called as Basidiomycetes. Basidiomycetes. See, in case of Basidiomycetes, these are basically parasitic in nature. For example, Ustilago, rust, Puccinia. You must have heard these names. Ustilago, rust, Puccinia. All are parasitic in nature. agaricus. You must have heard about puffballs, mushrooms, all come under class Basidiomycetes. So, vegetative reproduction in Basidiomycetes is very common. The morphology is, here is, they are septate having cross walls, they are having branching also. And in case of Basidiomycetes, it has been observed that vegetative reproduction is very common. For example, through fragmentation, vegetative reproduction through fragmentation is very common. Though conidia is not observed here, formation of conidia is not observed, but fragmentation is very common. In case of sexual reproduction, sex organs are not formed, though sexual reproduction happen here. But sex organs are not formed. Well, now let us talk about class Basidiomycetes. Okay, let us talk about Basidiomycetes. See, in order to make you understand, I am drawing a small diagram so that it will make you seen this figure, which is very common observed in the wood logs. This is called as pilus. This is the stipe, and these are the gills. Very, very common diagram as such. Now, these gills contain a number of basidium. Basidium are the structures which give rise to basidiospores exogenously. Now, gills have number of, this is actually called as basidium. Which give rise to basidiospores exogenously. These are all basidiospores, and they are produced exogenously. You can see there is no outer covering. That is the reason why I am calling them exogenously. They are produced exogenously. Now, they can be liberated outside the, and they can fall on the soil, and after some time they may develop to produce mycelium, and then later on to have a fruiting body. This fruiting body is actually called as basidiocarp. Basidiocarp. So this is how the sexual reproduction takes place. See, what happens is, there is a small mistake. See, the spores are released from the basidiospores. They will fall on the soil, and they will form thin filaments. As you can see here, they are forming thin filaments, each having a different stain. Now, this can be of said to be plus stain, and this can be said to be of minus stain. then what happen is each of them get fused together after some time. They are touching each other. They are coming in very close contact with each other. And when their protoplasm, fuses, they are getting in very close contact with each other, and when their protoplasm fuses, they take a shape where, see, the two nucleus belonging to two different strains are present in the same cell but still not getting fused. You can see it from the diagram. These are the two nuclei belonging to two different strains but not getting fused together. Now at this stage, it is called as, this is called as dikaryon, or the phase is called as dikaryon phase. Dikaryon, condition is dikaryon, where the nuclei, though present in the same cell, are not getting fused. So this filament, or you can say this hyphae, will ultimately give rise to a structure called as mycelium, and sporadically they will appear on the soil. Some part will be inside the soil and some part will appear outside the soil in form of a fruiting body, which is called as basidiocarp. This is the structure. Some part will be inside the soil. Like, suppose this is a soil, it is growing inside the soil like this. Still it is not fused. It is growing like this inside the soil. Is growing like this, but sporadically at certain juncture they will appear like this. And this is a part of fruiting body. In the gills part of the fruiting body lies the basidium on which the spores develop. The four basidiospores are developed, and since the basidiospores contain the nuclei of both the two different strains belonging to two different mycelium, naturally it is called as sexual reproduction. These spores, after getting liberated, they form a thyll filaments or a hyphae. They get in contact with each other and fusion of their protoplasm occurs, giving rise to a condition which is called as dikaryon. These dikaryon are present inside the soil. Sporadically they will appear above, on the above part of the soil, and that will be called as fruiting body. This life cycle will be repeated again and again. So this is the life cycle of basidiomycetes. Okay. Now, I have already told you examples of basidiomycetes include agaricus, mushrooms, eustilago, rusts, puccinia, etc. Now, let us talk about last class. three class already I have discussed. This is the last class which I am going to discuss, and that will be called as deuteromycetes. See, members of the deuteromycetes do not show any kind of sexual reproduction. So any organism, any fungi belonging to deuteromycetes, if in the future it has been discovered that it is having a sexual stage, that has been put into either of the class, either basidiomycetes or ascomycetes, they shift either to the ascomycetes class or they shift to the basidiomycetes class. So these are also called as fungi imperfecti because they do not have any sexual stage. They do not have any sexual stage. Yes, they reproduce through asexual reproduction, and that is through conidia, which I have already discussed. Conidia is a structure which is present on a special hyphae called as conidiopores, P-H-O-R-E-S. And it does not have an outer covering. They are naked, and that is the reason why they are called as exogenously produced. If suppose there is a membrane outside, they will be called as endogenously produced. But in case of conidia, it is always exogenously produced. There is no membrane outside. The membrane is not present outside. As I have told you already about conidia formation in class Ascomycetes. So here basically asexual reproduction takes place, and that is through conidia. Example of Deuteromycetes include Trichoderma. You must have heard this name. You will see it in NCERT. Qualitotrichum. Etc. So this is all about Qualitotrichum, Trichoderma, etc. This is all about various classes of fungi. I hope you like my discussion. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.